Hi, welcome to the demo of the PDF Butler Converter Lightning component. We have created a .config or a few .configs, and we of course want to show these or create the documents from our, in this case, the opportunity. Okay, how to go about that? Let's take a look. We go to the edit page. We are in a Lightning situation, so let's drag drop the PDF Butler components onto the page. Okay, see, it's now there. I'm just going to switch off a couple of things. They will be handled later in the demo. And the first step to do is to add .config identifiers IDs to the to this overview. Okay, so we just copy paste the IDs from the URL bar. So this is one, a comma. It has to be a comma separated list of IDs. And let's take another one. Let's call it data source demo. Okay, so just two IDs. These are there now. As you can see that the overview is already filling up. So if I save this, go back, and on my opportunity, of course, there is now the .configs that I've defined. And if I just click the PDF button, it will generate me a perfect looking quote as I defined it. So perfect, the overview of my quote. So yeah, just as I expected, looking good. Let's go back to the edit page, because now we need to further configure that the behavior on our quote is exactly how we want it to be. Okay, so first step, locales. PDF Butler is all about formatting numbers, dates, currencies. So, and these are all, of course, dependent on the locale that your current customer, not a user, the customer is working in. So a locale is a combination of language and country. So in every language and every country has a specific formatting for the numbers, specific formatting for the dates. So this is where PDF Butler, of course, uses that formatting as the customer would expect it. So I just going to enable locales. And as you can see here, a text box would show up. And if I just save that one, go back, let's give it a test. If I fill in, for instance, FR, so French in, let's take French, Belgium. So that's the Belgium is a country where I live. French is the language that some of my Belgium colleagues speak. I speak Dutch. So I have my locale, I generate a PDF. And so normally the PDF should be, see, this is already in French. So the date is already formatted in French. And also all of the numbers, they are formatted as the French speaking Belgians would like it. Okay, so that seems cool. Maybe let's try another one. Let's try AN underscore Great Britain. So if I now generate the document, you would see that, of course, this is now in English and all of the numbers are in pounds. So because that's, of course, the currency in England. That's not much about multi-currency, so we have to tackle that in a different way. But this is just formatting our in the way that our user is configured. So having to type this here is, of course, not very user-friendly. So we, of course, want to support some information that's coming from the page. Go back to our component. I'm going to say that I'm going to switch off this one, and I'm going to say that this one is actually a field on our page. So instead of typing it, which is not user friendly, I can just identify the API name of a field, and this primary contact locale is actually this field here, contact primary locale, and it sets to English Belgium. So yeah, it's not really it's a language we speak here in Belgium. We speak every language. So this is how we set it. Okay. Now let's give it a try, save that one, go back. And if I generate this one, it will be all in English. So just open it up. It will be all in English. And of course, you will see that the number formatting here is different. It's Euro again, because I said it would be Belgium and it would be English. So, but you see that there is a dot here, a comma here, a Euro sign in front, while the other ones had a Euro sign in the back and a comma instead of a dot. So number formatting, date formatting, all looks great. Next up. Okay. So we have now, I've shown you, if I switch here to French, let's take an, or let's switch to Dutch, to German, sorry, let's switch to German. So we have here a German, you see that the locale immediately changed because it's a formula linked to our contact. Okay, let's generate this one. And what you will see is that there is a German date. Of course, a German date in an English document is not very interesting. So what we have here in PDF Butler is the concept of alternatives. And the concept of alternatives speaks about these multiple documents that you can link to the same configuration that is currently there. So we have a French document, a German document, a Dutch document, and an English document all linked to the same configuration. So no duplication in configuration, just a separate template for the different languages. So what we actually want to show in this case is our German template, our German translation of the template. How we go about that? Edit page. Okay, let's tackle this one again. So we can, of course, say that we want to fill in the alternative. So on the screen, you can just fill in the name of the alternative. Let's quickly take a look. Okay, I enter DE here, for instance. So that is the German alternative, as we could see here. So DE is for Germany. I click the button. Now it will take the locale of the user, and but it will also, as you can see, take the German translated document. So we have all our dates in German, we have our currencies in German, as the Germans like it, and we have our document in German. So perfect. Everything looks great. Of course, again, not very user-friendly. What we want is this field, which is also a formula in this case, linked to our contact to define which alternative that we want. So let's go back to the edit page. Okay, I switch off the alternative and I enter the API name of the field. Okay, so let's save this one, go back. Okay, let's click the button. Now it should immediately know that it should take the German document. See, everything is now in German, defined on our settings of our contact. If I change the contact to, I think the name was Jean-François. Yeah, okay, let's save this one. You see that this is French. So if I click the button now, of course, you would expect that there is a French document. Yeah, the date is in French. And of course, our currencies are formatted. See, there is no dot anymore between the for the thousand separator. So this is how it's formatted in French according to the international standards. Okay, further on, this is not the end yet. So the component has a lot of features. Okay, so in some cases you do not want to you do not want everybody to be able to generate PDFs, so you can just give here a list of profiles, you comma separated, so it's the name of the profile, And for everybody who can generate PDFs, same for the Word, anybody that wants to generate Word. So in many cases, we have customers that say, yeah, everybody can generate PDFs, but only the senior salespeople, responsibles can actually generate Word documents so that they can edit them. And of course, the same for Excel. So yeah. Fill in your profile and you will see these buttons appearing, not appearing. The Excel button will only appear when the record type of the .config is, of course, an Excel, which sounds logical. Okay, so auto-download, you have seen that. Every time we generate a document, it's downloaded automatically. So, but we can also show a preview. So in this case, it will both download the document and show the preview of the document. Okay, let's take a look. I click the button, so the document is generated. It will be in French, and our previewer is already loading. See, this is our preview of the document perfectly on the screen. And this is, of course, also perfectly mobile enabled. So everybody on a mobile can also check out their documents in the previewer. So, looks good. And you saw that it's also downloaded here. So our document is there. We're nearly there. Lightning component also has a very cool feature for packs, but packs are a great way to reuse existing .configs, combine .configs, so generate or merge multiple .configs together, combine .configs with actions to take, send it out for email, send it out to a digital service, digital signature tool like SignButler. So for packs, a lot of options. There is a video on packs, so make sure to check that one out as well, and you will learn all about how to use this. And then, of course, when you want to use this on a community, then you have to fill in the record ID. Please just follow this explanation. So the record ID item has to be filled in this field. And last but not least, if you want to set some visibility rules here, for instance, I only want to show this depending on the stage. And the stage has to be equal to negotiation review, for instance. Okay, done. Then I will save it and go back, and you will see that the component is not there. So what a lot of my customers do is actually add 10 multiple components on this screen, and dependent on where they are, which documents can be generated, should be generated, which actions can be taken, should be taken. So all of this stuff defines which button here or which lightning component here is shown. So as you can see, only shown when it's negotiation review. Looks great, all is there. Okay, this was the video on the lightning component for the converter. So please check out more of our videos on YouTube and on our academy.